Welcome back to our course on Project 2013. I'm going to look at touch in this short section. If you're not intending to use touch, maybe not even interested in using touch or how people use it, then you can pretty much skip this section. If you are going to use touch, or if you're considering using touch, then it's quite a short section and I think it's very useful to go through it with me. The first thing I'd like to point out to you is this blog post on office.com, using the new Office with Touch. You can find that by googling it or by going to microsoft.com and searching, but it is an extremely good post which basically gives the background to how Microsoft went about addressing touch in Office 2013 in general. From the point of view of touch, Project is part of Office 2013, so virtually everything that you see in this blog post is relevant to Project. Now, I'm not going to go through all the detail here. It's a really interesting document to read. It not only gives the background to why they did things the way that they did, but it also goes into some detail of the particular requirements of different aspects of using a fairly advanced piece of software with a touch device. They recognize in particular that one of the key issues with using a touch device, as we'll see during this course, is the accuracy of touching part of the screen, particularly if you've got fairly fat fingers like mine, in comparison with accessing maybe just a single point on a screen using a mouse. Now, if you go through this article, it gives background to the vision for touch by Microsoft, the sort of guidelines they followed, and then some particular issues like targeting, which is really the targeting a specific point on the screen. And then things like the changes they made to the ribbon. Now, we're going to look at the use of the ribbon with touch in the next section, so I won't go into that here. And then further down, they talk about other user interface elements. A good example is the color picker. That's not particularly relevant to Project, although you do use it in a couple of situations in Project. But again, the general principle is to take the conventional color picker and just make everything bigger to be easier to operate with your fingers. Anyway, it's an extremely interesting and informative article, and I do recommend that you go through and take the time to just read through it. I will be referring to it from time to time and many of the points that it makes later on in the course, and in many ways it forms the background to many aspects of touch in Project 2013. And the other important article, which is also on Microsoft.com, is the Office Touch Guide. Now, you may have seen this in an earlier version where it was basically a text document. The version that's available as I'm recording this course has got some little video demonstrations of some aspects of using touch. Now, again, I'm not going to go through all of these now, because the ones that are particularly relevant I'm going to go through at the various points in the course. But just take the first example. Zoom in and out. If I click on zoom in and out, you get a little demonstration of using stretch and pinch. Watch again. The idea is, if you want to zoom into something, you stretch. If you want to zoom out, you pinch. So zooming in by stretching your fingers apart gets you closer to the subject, and then zooming out by pinching gets you farther away. Now, for each of the different kinds of gesture with touch, there's a little video demonstration in this article, Office Touch Guide. So scroll. So there's a demonstration there of how to scroll through a document on screen. I'll just play that again. Notice how the user is basically touching the screen. You see a little sort of flash as they touch the screen, and then they hold it as they scroll through the document. Now, if you are intending to use touch, I suggest you locate this document and work through all of the different gestures, basic gestures, gestures with shapes and objects. Again, not particularly relevant to Project 2013, many of these, but some of them are. And then further down, particularly text, selecting text and formatting text, we will be looking at using touch later on. And then there are some specifics related to Excel and PowerPoint. There are none specifically in relation to Project, but many of the earlier ones are relevant. Now, I am going to be demonstrating touch at various points on the course, and as I introduce each new gesture, I'll go through an example. Unfortunately, it's not practical on a course like this to do everything using both touch and the mouse and keyboard. It would mean doing everything twice, which would get a little bit tedious for everybody, including me. So I'm primarily going to use mouse and keyboard on the course, and I'll introduce touch at various points. I'll use examples with touch, but primarily it'll be mouse and keyboard. And if you are using a touch device, I suggest that you practice using that right from the outset, and you will find that virtually everything in Project is perfectly possible using touch. And in my experience so far, if you're using touch with Project 2013, really the only area where I still have a little bit of difficulty is when I need to target something very precisely, and in some situations that is still quite difficult, but maybe with a bit more practice I'll get over that as well. That's it for this section. I'll see you in the next one.
Hi everyone, Simon here from Simon Says It. Thanks for watching this video. If this is your first time here, I'd love for you to subscribe. Every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, new videos are uploaded to the Simon Says It channel here on YouTube. Just click on the subscribe button right over there. If you're interested in taking your Microsoft Project 2013 training to the next level, you can get 19 hours of Project 2013 training offered by Simon Says It. Just check out the About section below this video with more details. We'll see you next week with additional videos.